Yeah, we're pulling away. We're just going to wedge in the door.
I'm By Reverend Renee Canales of Our Lady of Hope Parish.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Dear God, you have made us one human race of one blood of all the people of the earth. Also, you have blessed us richly with a world of many languages, cultures, and traditions. I thank you today for the many contributions which our Hispanic brothers and sisters have made as we celebrate Hispanic Month and continue to make to our great country, the United States of America. Enable us always to learn from and appreciate each other. Make us even stronger as one nation because of our diverse gifts and experiences. Enrich our minds and our hearts and our spirits so we can continue to serve you, and especially in the one that we meet every day. And we make this prayer through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please be seated. This regular meeting of the Township Council is being held in accordance with the scheduled meetings of Township Council established and adopted by Township Council with the schedule designated time and date and place of this meeting. Adequate public notice of this meeting has been provided pursuant to the provisions of the Open Public Meetings Act. We are using an electronic amplifying and recording device in order to obtain a clear and audible record, and we request all those wishing to speak be recognized and state your name and address directly to the microphone. The recording device will be solely utilized by the Township Clerk's Office for the preparation of minutes and shall be the official record of the Township Council meetings. Madam Clerk, may I have the roll call, please?
Mr. Hutchison?
Present.
Mr. Schmidt?
Present.
Mrs. Stubbs?
Present.
Mrs. Winters? Mr. Neal?
Here.
Mrs. Strada?
She has a work commitment. I'm sorry, Ms. Winters has a family emergency.
Thank you. Mr. Mercado?
Present.
Mr. Lechner?
Here.
Chief Earl?
Here.
Mr. Carlemere?
Here.
Mr. Cardis?
Here.
This evening we celebrate Hispanic Heritage Month here in Gloucester Township. We have a special presentation before we start that. I'm going to ask the mayor and the chief if they can come up to the microphone. Okay. And Assemblywoman Mascara. Thank
Well, thank you, and good evening, and welcome to Gloucester Township's celebration of Hispanic Heritage Month. As many of you probably are aware, this week Gloucester Township is hosting the 2016 National Police K-9 Championships, and we have teams from throughout the country that have come into Gloucester Township that have won their regionals, and now the best dogs are here. So please, if you're interested in watching them, they're here all week, and then Thursday evening we have one big community kind of closing ceremonies where we'll be featuring the winning dogs and also food and fireworks. So we would encourage everyone to please participate and really see how well trained these dogs are and how much the handlers put into training them. Because we are celebrating Hispanic Heritage Month, we wanted to especially recognize one of those officers, Officer Mario Gutierrez Silva, and I would ask the officer to please come forward. Officer Silva, along with his wife Laura, please. His wife Laura, his daughter Zara, and his son Caleb, traveled 2,000 miles from Jalisco, Mexico, to participate in these championships. So we wanted to especially recognize him today and his family. Certainly, he is very brave. He and his wife are very brave. I don't know if I could have traveled 2,000 miles when my children were young. I wouldn't have hair. I think I would have probably pulled it out. But that's a long way to travel, and it shows the dedication that Officer Silva has with his canine partner, Turco. And we're really, really proud to have him here. And on behalf of our township and the residents of Gloucester Township, we wanted to present to him a proclamation that shows his commitment to law enforcement and his community back home. So thank you for joining us. We certainly appreciate that.
Thank you, Mayor. Good evening, everyone. I wanted to take a moment to present to Officer Silva our coin. So every Gloucester Township police officer that graduates from the Police Academy is issued this coin, which lists the words of compassion, integrity, fairness, and respect. So it's my honor to present the Gloucester Township Police coin to Officer Silva. And we've heard from the Mayor the great commitment that both he and his family are making to travel here to the United States Police Canine Association Nationals, which is really about training and improving and just commitment to the law enforcement profession. So on behalf of all the men and women of the Gloucester Township Police Department, I present our coin to Officer Silva.
Proclamation. Since our founding, our nation has drawn strength from the diversity of our people, with faith and passion, a sturdy work ethic, and profound devotion to family. Hispanics have helped carry forward our legacy as a vibrant beacon of opportunity for all. Whether their ancestors have been here for generations or they are among the newest members of our American family, they represent many countries and cultures, each adding their own distinct and dynamic perspective to our country's story. In celebration of National Hispanic Heritage Month, we honor the contributions Hispanic Americans have made throughout our history, and we highlight an important part of the rich diversity that keeps our community strong. Hispanic Americans have had a lasting impact on our history, have helped drive hard-won progress for all people. They are the writers, the singers and musicians that enrich our arts and humanities, the innovative entrepreneurs steering our economy. They are scientists and engineers revolutionizing our ways of life and making sweeping new discoveries. The advocates leading the way for social and political change. They are the brave men and women in uniform who commit themselves to defending our most cherished ideals at home and abroad, and their lasting achievement and devotion to our nation exemplify the tenacity and perseverance embedded in our national character. This month, let us reflect on the countless ways in which Hispanics have contributed to our nation's success, and let us reaffirm our commitment to expanding opportunity and building an even brighter future for all. Let us all embrace the diversity that strengthens us and continues striving to ensure the American dream is within reach for generations of Hispanics to come. To honor the achievements of Hispanics in America, the Congress by Public Law 100-402 has amended, has authorized and requested that the President of the United States to issue annually a proclamation designating September 15th through October 15th as National Hispanic Heritage Month. Therefore, I, David Mayer, Mayor of Township of Gloucester, and I, Orlando Mercado, President of the Gloucester Township Council, do hereby proclaim September 15th through October 15th, 2016, as National Hispanic Heritage Month.
I call upon public officials, educators, librarians, and all Americans to observe this month with appropriate ceremonies, activities, and programs. This evening, we are celebrating Hispanic Heritage Month. This is something that we started in 2006 when we had one recipient. And now we've gotten to the point where we have to limit the amount of nominations. There is a committee that's put together that is appointed by the mayor, and I want to introduce the two committee members, Michael Acevedo and Josie Washington. You can come up, please.
Good evening. Buenas noches. All right, there we go. Welcome to Gloucester Township, celebration of Hispanic Heritage Month. Like the council president said, my name is Michael Acevedo, and tonight I am joined by my fellow committee member, Josie Washington, who is over there. You're going to hear from her in a second. During National Hispanic Heritage Month, we recognize the contributions made and the important presence of Hispanic and Latino Americans to the United States and celebrate their heritage and culture. Every year, National Hispanic Heritage Month is observed and celebrated by Americans across the nation. The celebration began in 1969 under President Lyndon B. Johnson and was made a month-long celebration in 1988 by Congress. Hispanic Heritage Month celebrates the contributions of Hispanic Americans to the country. At the same time, Chile, Costa Rica, El Salvador, Guatemala, Honduras, Mexico, Nicaragua, and Belize celebrate their independence. Hispanic Heritage Month is a wonderful opportunity to recognize Hispanic culture and to celebrate the achievements of Hispanic Americans who have had a great influence on America. Generations of Hispanic Americans have enriched our nation by making contributions in science, education, the arts, and politics.
Hispanics have had a profound and positive influence on our country through their strong commitment to family, faith, hard work, and service. They've enhanced and shaped our nation's national character with centuries-old traditions that reflect the multi-ethnic and multicultural customs of their community. The term Hispanic or Latino refers to Puerto Rican, South or Central American, or other Spanish culture or origin, regardless of race. On the 2010 census form, people of Spanish, Hispanic, and or Latino origin could identify themselves as Mexican, Mexican-American, Chicano, Puerto Rican, Cuban, or another Hispanic, Latino, or Spanish origin. Today, 55 million people, or 17% of the American population, are of Hispanic or Latino origin. Please share with us in this special annual tribute by learning and celebrating the Hispanic and Latino Americans who have positively influenced our community through their good works.
President, you can introduce them.
Good evening, I'm Rosalyn Rosado, and I'd like to introduce our entertainment, which is my father, Elias, and my brother, Roberto. They're going to play the congas and timbales. Ready for some sabor.
Thank you.
Well, I have the honor of bringing up the first recipient this evening, and before I do that, Ms. Petit, if I could ask you to join me. Ms. Petit, from the principal of Highland High School, nominated Christina Colazzo. So, Christina, if you could please join me as well. Christina is a vice principal at Highland High School, has been there 3 years. And always is so welcoming when I go to the school and talk to the students, and certainly always smiling and great interaction with her students. She began overseeing, when she came to Highland High School, she oversaw the Community Relations Committee, and that is a committee that takes the students and looks at opportunities in Gloucester Township to help others, and it's great certainly for our community, but also gives the students the satisfaction of giving back to their community. And so she really spearheaded that committee, and I think has more members today than 3 years ago. So it keeps growing, and that's what we want. And giving back to our community is certainly something that is very important, and certainly something that Christina is teaching her students. She is also organizes the Senior Citizens Prom, the Senior Citizens Dinner and Play, the Haunted Hallways, that sounds like fun. Yeah, all right. And the very important program, the Peer Mentoring Program. And she is an active member of the Gloucester Township Kiwanis Club. Always taking on extra activities at school. Takes on the Multicultural Fair, the Art Show, and the Water Walk. And as Ms. Petit said in her letter, Christina is a great role model for our students and faculty. And so today we present to you this small token of our appreciation of what you do in our community on behalf of myself and the Township of Gloucester, as well as the county freeholders and the state of the legislature as well. So we thank you once again, Christina, for all that you do. Congratulations.
I'd just like to thank Christina for all that she does. I'm very appreciative of all the effort that she gives, goes above and beyond what is expected of her, and she has absolutely taught our students on the importance of giving back. So I thank you for that.
I just would like to thank the council and Mayor and Ms. Petit for this honor today. It's a privilege to be here. I thank my parents, because both of them have instilled in me community service and giving back. Without them, I wouldn't be here. And really, I'm just proud to be able to represent the Hispanic culture, and to show that we can strive to be better and stronger and to keep our faith alive and to keep giving back to your community. So I'm proud to be here, and I'm proud to be part of Gloucester Township through my high school. Highland High School is my family now, so I thank you for this honor.
Did Krista Gonzalez get here? Okay. On her way.
We want to wait until she gets here. That's fine. That's on her way. Wait. Why don't we wait?
Okay.
Yeah.
We'll save her.
Saying I had a girlfriend, and believe it or not, I had a girlfriend in college, and she was from Puerto Rico, Rio Piedras, more specifically Trujillo Alto. That's as good as it gets. And I took her out. I was really shy, but I took her out to the diner one time, and she paid, and we ordered something. I was from Linden Mall. I had no money. So I'm sitting there, and she was trying to order something. And she kept saying, orange juice. She couldn't pronounce the J's. So that leads me to my problem here. Is it Jarlene? How do I pronounce your name?
Jarlene.
Jarlene, fabulous. Come on up here. Jarlene was nominated by two people, her principal, Tasha Giddens, and her vice principal, Gary Saunders. And they wrote something for you. I'm going to read that for you, okay? Jarlene Gonzalez is a senior at Timber Creek Regional High School. Simply said, Jarlene is one of the nicest people to ever attend Timber Creek. This is the sentiment that I hear over and over again about Jarlene Gonzalez. Every day I see her, she constantly puts a smile on my face. She is caring, courteous, and kind. She's a captain of the girls' track and field team, 110 high hurdles, and the 400. I think that that is the toughest race on the track. And I think Sydney McLaughlin might agree. Did you ever run against Sydney? You did? She's amazing. Her coaches say whatever event she's needed for, she jumps right in and performs at a high level. Jarlene is a member of the ladies group that lends leadership to girls who are less fortunate. She has a strong consciousness for community service. Every year she is involved with Timber Creek's food drive to feed the homeless. She does the breast cancer walk with her church to bring attention to and raise money to fight this horrific disease. Last year she was instrumental in Timber Creek's pocketbook drive, working with a family shelter in Camden. Jarlene does all these things because she wants to make a difference. Her positive attitude and caring personality make her a champion in my book, and we are fortunate to have her. So, I'm looking at these awards and the recipients for today, and I was watching TV this morning, and there was an athlete who passed, and I didn't really appreciate him because I thought of him as a pitcher, but he was a Cuban American. And Jose Fernandez, and he's no longer with us. But I listened to everything that he did, and it makes me think of what you do. You give to the community. When Jose got his first check, the Rookie of the Award, Rookie of the Year Award, he took the $20,000 and he gave it to a young girl to use for charitable purposes. And that resonated throughout the Cuban community in Miami, and he didn't do it one time, he kept doing it. So I hope that what's on this piece of paper is just the beginning of what you do in your life, because you'll make a significant impact. And so with that, Gloucester Township, the county freeholders and the state legislators wanted to give you these awards. And you can say something if you would like.
I'm so thankful to be up here, and I thank my parents for always guiding me and, you know, teaching me right from wrong. And I'm very thankful for my principal, my vice principal. They're very kind, and I just have, like, such a good relationship with them. And I'm thankful to run at a school in Timber Creek. And this is just the beginning of giving, because I feel like we have so much, and we need to appreciate it. Because a lot of people out there don't have a lot, and my goals in the future are to be a doctor and join this organization that gives around the world while lifting their spirits up. And yeah, that's really what I want to do, and I thank God for everything, because I always put Him first. So thank you.
We have a few students that are running a little late because they're at a practice or at some other event they had to attend, but they're going to try to make their best to get here. So we're going to move ahead to our next recipient, who is our youngest recipient here tonight. And look, she's smiling already. Marjorie Hernandez. Marjorie, can you please come up here? Marjorie was nominated by her principal and vice principal at C.W. Lewis School, and also by her English as a second language teacher, Ms. Ball. Ms. Ball has been in this chamber, council chambers, before, nominating students, supporting students. When I first met her, I thought she was Latina, right? When you first met her? She's from Turkey, okay? But she has picked up a Spanish accent over the years. But every time a student comes into C.W. Lewis School or into our district, Miss Ball embraces them, and she serves as a champion for them and always speaks very highly of them. So Miss Ball had nominated her, and a few things that she said about Marjorie is that she's a pleasant student, a dynamic individual, a person where the sky is the limit. She came here 2 years ago from Honduras, and when she says thank you later on, you're going to hear her English. It is fantastic. I said, how long have you been here? She stopped by my office today. I said, she was 2 years. But what she has picked up, when I asked her where she grew up in Honduras, in the capital city, Tegucigalpa, right? And I asked her, what is the difference between Honduras and being here? And she said, opportunities. There are opportunities here. And she's proud to be here in the United States. Now, she's going to go back, of course, to her homeland eventually and visit, but she's proud to be here. When I asked her what she wanted to do in life, she said she either wanted to be a lawyer or be an actress. So I said, so a lawyer, she had said, well, you have to be dedicated, you have to be smart. And I said, an actress? And she goes, dramatic. So, and her favorite actress, Marjorie, but what's her last name again? How do you know that? You watch the novelas, huh? For those who don't know what novelas is, that's soap operas in Spanish. It's your job, okay. But she is pleasant. She has a wonderful personality. She has been a true leader and a real joy to have at C.W. Lewis School. So on behalf of Mayor and Council, Margie, I want to present this award to you. Presented to you in recognition of exemplary leadership, outstanding service, and dedication to the people of Gloucester Township, September of 2016, presented by Gloucester Township, David, our mayor, and council. Congratulations.
Well, good evening, everybody. I just want to say thank you to everybody, especially my mom and my dad that always support me. And they're there for me, never let me down. My sisters and Miss Ball, that she would be helpful to me in school. I just want to thank you to everybody.
And now, musical entertainment again. Ready, round two? Trying to get those two here for the last few years, so I want to thank you, the Rosados. Thank you very much. That was ha ha ha, wasn't it? So our next recipient has served on part of our committee for the last few years and has been an immense help to our committee and to me as a professional here. Our next recipient is Rosalyn Rosado, the Vice Principal of Ann Mullen Middle School. So I always write things down, but I never take a look at it. Rosalyn was born and raised in Hamilton, New Jersey. She attended Hamilton Public Schools, graduated, and went to, I still call it Trent State, but College of New Jersey. Forgot, alumni. I went to Stockton. We had an inferiority complex with your school, so I'm not going to lie. So. She attended College of New Jersey, graduated with a Bachelor of Science in Education and Psychology, then started teaching in her hometown as a bilingual ESL teacher in first grade. Did a short stint there and then went to Texas. When she went to Texas and started her family, she went and received her master's degree in educational leadership from Tarleton State University in Texas. Again, she was a teacher there in bilingual education in ESL. She came back to New Jersey, back again to Hamilton, and once again was a bilingual teacher in ESL. In addition to that, she picked up some certifications along the way, too many to name, but one of them was a master therapist, master level therapist in counseling, where she deals with Latino families, primarily going into the home and seeing things that perhaps aren't the nicest things to see, but nevertheless doing great work in that. After that, she did a short stint in Willingboro, worked for a 21st Century Program, which is an after-school program for at-risk students. But she came back to the area and became the vice principal now at Buna Middle School, using her master's degree in educational administration. In the summer of 2013, or spring of 2013, she saw an opening in the Gloucester Township Public School District. She applied, interviewed, and was hired in August of 2013. Being the first Latino vice principal or principal in the Gloucester Township Public School District. Christina, you may be the first in Black Horse Pike Regional. We'll look it up, okay? She started at Erie Elementary School as the vice principal there and immediately made an impact on that particular school. So we all know Hispanic Heritage Month is September 15th to October 15th. So she instituted some of the things that she did in different schools, celebrating the culture of Latinos at your elementary school, bringing in speakers. She even had me read to the class, and brought in food. And in fact, one day she did the Pledge of Allegiance in English and Spanish, and she was criticized for that. This person whose family is involved in the military, who loves their country, she was criticized for that. And I remember placing a phone call to her that day. I said, you keep doing what you're doing, okay? You're sharing our culture with people, okay? You're standing up and you're saying the Pledge of Allegiance both in English and Spanish. And I invited you that year to come here, and you did it in Spanish. So thank you very much. After that year at Erie Elementary School, she went to Mullen Middle School as the middle school vice principal and has been there for the last 2 years and has continued to make changes within our district. In fact, in her personal life, she's involved very much with her parish, St. Joseph Parish, where she serves Father Renee. Yeah. You go punch the ticket to heaven. There you go, Father Renee. Where she's involved in translating the bulletin that's provided there, serves as a translator, a website, posts things on the website and on the Facebook. She is also has served as the vice president of the Puerto Rican Civic Association in Hamilton, which is an organization that has been, I would say, what, 50 plus years in Hamilton, and now currently serves as its president of the Puerto Rican Civic Association. But once again, I think it's a blessing that we have her in our school district, in our community. She serves as a role model to individuals, not only that were at Erie Elementary School, not just for the faculty and staff, but also the individuals at Ann Mullen Middle School, and also the individuals that work with her on a day-to-day basis. So therefore, that's why she was my nominee for Hispanic Heritage Month. So on behalf of Mayor and Council, Rosen, I want to thank you very much for your contributions to our community in recognition of your exemplary leadership, outstanding service, and dedication to the people of Gloucester Township. Thank you very much. Also, one more thing. So, because I've been trying to get her brother and father here for many years, I keep putting her on the committee so she can get talent. But she has served on our Hispanic Heritage Month committee the last 3 years. This year we gave her a break because she's an honoree. But you're back next year. Okay. So, well, thank you very much and congratulations.
I want to say thank you to Mayor, Council, all of Gloucester Township, Police Department. You have adopted me, you know. I came to this district, to this township. Being from Atlantic County, you know, I was the outsider, but I was welcomed with open arms, and quite honestly, I treasure each and every one of you. I work closely with them. Anything that I ask for, you know, they're there. Whatever they need from me, I'm more than willing to help them out. Love the community, love the students, the parents, everybody that I work with. So I feel like I am a Gloucester Township, you know, citizen here, you know. And I love all the kids. I love all of you, you know, and I plan to be here for quite some time. So I'm very honored to, you know, have received this. So thank you very much. Muchísimas gracias.
Okay, our next recipient is Mrs. Melissa Hernandez. Before the evening started, I went up to Mrs. Hernandez and I said, are you nervous? And she said, no. I said, well, you're probably going to say a couple things after she said, now I'm nervous. So one of the things, I'm always envious of folks that can speak ad lib without reading a paper. But if I don't read this paper, then I'm going to do you an injustice. There are so many adjectives that the people that nominated you, Principal Kasha Giddens and Vice Principal Mr. Saunders. So I'm going to read this. They wrote some very nice things about Mrs. Hernandez. So here we go. Mrs. Melissa Hernandez had been a member of the Black Horse Pike Regional School District family for over 10 years. She's a graduate of Rowan University. Melissa is a loving wife to one of our math teachers, Mr. Brian Ernst, sitting right there, and a devoted mother to her two beautiful daughters, Sophia and Viviana. She is proud to be of Mexican and Cuban descent. She uses her rich cultural background to teach and inspire her students to have a passion for the Spanish language and culture. Mrs. Hernandez is appreciated and respected by her students and community not just for her excellence in the classroom, but for her relentless dedication outside the classroom as well. She has always been involved in a club or extracurricular activity here at Timber Creek. Currently, she is the advisor of the freshman class. Last year, she organized an unforgettable senior prom and senior class trip to Disney. Her hard work and dedication is apparent in her department too. She's involved every year with World Language Week activities and the World Language Honor Society induction ceremony. She's appreciated by her fellow department members and the faculty and staff of Timber Creek High School. Melissa goes above and beyond her duties, staying after school for many hours to help her students with academics and with all the work that is being involved in being a class advisor. To sum it up, Mrs. Hernandez is very worthy of the honor of representing Timber Creek High School in recognition of Hispanic Heritage Month. So on behalf of Gloucester Township, I present you this award in recognition of your exemplary leadership, outstanding service, and dedication to the people of Gloucester Township.
Like you said, yes, I'm nervous. I don't like to speak in front of people. But my husband said, talk to you guys like you're my class. So I am thankful and honored to be up here. I want to thank the Timber Creek family. They are my family. I do everything that I do without even thinking people know that I do it. I want to thank Mayor and the council for allowing me to receive this award. And I want to thank my family, my husband and my children and my mother.
Next recipient is Barbara Marinara. Is that right? Earlier we heard Mariori Hernandez, and one of the things that she recognized here in this country, which may have been different from her, was it Honduras? Was the opportunities that come about living in this country. And this recipient, her family, takes full advantage of those opportunities. Your father has a transportation service company, and your mother started a beauty salon. That's what's great about this country. It really does afford all of us opportunities. We can be what we want to be. I see young people up here, like the recipient that Jarlene, she wants to be a doctor. I grew up in Lindenwald, and I didn't know what I wanted to be. And I sense that sometimes young people sense opportunities more so if they come from somewhere else. Your family came from where? El Salvador? And I marvel at that. The courage that it takes to do what your family has done. And you know what's funny? It resonates from the top down. Your sister, I gave the same award to. How many years ago? 4 years ago. It starts from the top. You're a wonderful person. I met this young person earlier tonight, and she wants to be a missionary. That's pretty amazing. Is there any more selfless thing that she could do? Me, I'm not that good. Okay, I'm really not. I went to the to a function called the Men of Malvern, and I'm there, and they're trying to convince people, I guess, that young people should become more involved with. What do you call it? The invocation?
Okay. With the vocation.
Yeah. And I looked at my buddy I'm with, and he said, I'd be so honored if my son became a priest. And I said, oh my goodness, I wouldn't have grandchildren. I mean, that's how my head works. But you want to be a missionary. And that's simply fabulous. So the person who nominated you wrote something very nice about you. And I'd like to read it as well. But my eyes are going on. So It says, it is with great pleasure that I submit to you the name of an outstanding student, Barbara Marinaro, as my nominee for recognition at the Hispanic Heritage Month celebration on Monday, September 26th. Barbara's an eighth grade student at Ann Mullen. She is pleasant, respectful, dedicated, and hardworking young lady. I believe all of that, by the way. I can honestly say that Barbara has a heart of gold. She enjoys helping the homeless alongside one of our teachers, Mr. Krill. She is also an altar server and choir member at Nuestra Samora Senora de Guadalupe. Now, I attended church the other day, and I looked at the young ladies at St. Agnes. Do they call it Our Lady of Hope or St. Agnes?
The name of the church is St. Agnes, but
yes.
The parish is Our Lady of Hope.
And I have four children, and I can honestly tell you not one of my children has been an altar server. Okay, so I get it, and I'm looking with admiration, saying, where did I go wrong? She even had the privilege to serve at one of the largest cathedrals twice. She takes pleasure in tutoring other students and walking her elderly neighbor's dog. Barbara also enjoys using her angelic voice as a member of our school choir. Barbara aspires to be a missionary when she grows up because she wants to help others. Barbara's favorite subject in school is English language arts because she loves to read and write. She loves to be able to creatively express her thoughts during writer's workshop. Barbara's diligence and dedication make her one of the most exemplary members of our National Junior Honor Society. She says her favorite teachers are Mr. Krill, Ms. Muller, Mr. Kraft, Mrs. Hepner, and Mr. Sanchez. These teachers have had an impact in her life. Barbara is very proud of her family. Her father came to the U.S. in 1985 when he was 12 years old. He first lived in Elizabeth. Her mother came to the U.S. in 1995 when she was 20 years old. She lived in Philly. Her parents knew each other back in El Salvador. And had married over there in 1994. They lived in Philly for 10 years. While in Philly, they had three beautiful daughters. In 2005, the Marinaro family moved to Sicklerville and made this their home. Barbara looks up to her parents as wonderful role models. They came to this country, have worked hard, and are successful entrepreneurs. I truly believe that Barbara Marinaro is an exemplary student and member of her community who exhibits remarkable leadership qualities and generously contributes to anyone in need without expecting anything in return. I sincerely hope that Barbara is one of the selected candidates to be honored at the Hispanic Heritage Month celebration. So that's what they have to say.
I'd like to thank God for giving me the strength to do all of this. Second, I'd like to thank Ms. Rosado for nominating me. I'd like to thank my sisters for making me a better person. And last but not least, my parents for making me proud to be a Hispanic. Together, we can make a change.
Good evening, my name is Andrea Stubbs, and I'd like to read about Miss Gabriella Alexander, if she would come forward, please. I say read because I'm the same. It's very important that I read, other than that I lose my place and get off point, we'll be here all night. But I proudly nominate Gabriella Alexander for her selfless support of not only the children of Blackwood Elementary, of which I am the principal, but also of different groups throughout the township. She's the president of my parent-teacher organization, is a major supporter of our school. I've been an administrator at Blackwood for almost 10 years, and Miss Alexander has been a fixture right there with me. She could be found in our hallways on a consistent basis, running an errand, organizing a fundraiser, coordinating parent volunteers, providing teachers a luncheon, working at the school store, holiday Christmas shop, always just asking me, is there anything that I can do? She's always willing to help and support children in any way she can. Ms. Alexander volunteers as a coach for her daughter's softball league and also for her daughter's basketball team. She is a full-time stay-at-home mom, and she is full-time. You can see her running all over the township, doing something for somebody. That's just who she is. Ms. Alexander and her husband, Douglas, have been married 17 years and have lived in the township for 6 years. She's a doting mother of Isabel, a freshman at Highland High School, Olivia, a sixth grader at C.W. Lewis Middle School, and Grace, a third grader at Blackwood Elementary School. I have tortured these girls because I always threatened to fail them so I could keep their mother one more year. I've tortured them. Grace, it's your turn. You're going to have to stay with me an extra year so I could keep your mom and dad with me. Miss Alexander, and we spoke today, but we didn't even have to have that conversation. She feels that it's important to set a good example as parents for our children, and she shows that every day. She states that she wants her children to see what good people can do, such as participating in community service during Martin Luther King Day or just volunteering to help others. And what better way than to see your parent committed to service? And she is committed. She is committed. We have been fortunate at Blackwood Elementary to have a parent so dedicated to the children in our township and in our schools. Ms. Alexander is so very kind and respected by all those who know and work with her. I don't know where she finds the time or energy to do what she does. She tires me out when she comes in the office. She dashes to and fro. I can't keep up with her. And she's always on the move. But I do hope she knows that we truly appreciate everything that she does. We truly do. And we've been blessed to have her at Blackwood Elementary School. So thank you, Ms. Alexander.
Thank you, Ms. Stubbs, Council, Mayor. Thank you so much, Gloucester Township. It's my honor to volunteer and to help out and set a good example for the girls. Thank you to my husband for being there for me. Mom, thank you for coming to this country over 30 years ago and not leaving. She thought about going back to Argentina, she didn't, and I hope to keep volunteering for years to come and get my kids involved as well so we can all make a difference in this township because we really love it here. Thank you.
Our next recipient who did dash in, I'm so glad to see him, Andreas Camacho. Would you come forward, please? I'm going to read some wonderful things about Andreas. Who was also nominated by his principal, Ms. Giddens, and Vice Principal Saunders. Andreas Camacho was a senior at Timber Creek Regional High School. He is a member of the Transition Project, which is a program that teachers select upperclassmen to work with underclassmen issues. Andreas is a four-year member of the Renaissance Club, the History Club, World Language Club, and Student Council. That's a lot. He's busy, too. He is an outstanding member of our varsity wrestling team, which he serves as captain, which is why he arrived late, because he had practice. So that's what a captain does. Andreas placed second in the districts last year. He also competed in regions. Andreas has a strong chance to be the regional champion this year. While Andreas is a positive contributor to the Timber Creek family, what separates him is his character and work ethic. Andreas will be inducted into the Men's Leadership Program this year. It is a select group of male students nominated by male faculty members for leadership and character. The one consistent thing you hear about Andreas is his work ethic. Every teacher I've spoken about raves about how hard he works and how focused he is. Andreas currently carries a 3.0 GPA and wants to pursue a degree in broadcasting journalism. He has interests in Temple University, Mammoth University, and Fairleigh Dickinson University. It is also added that his positive, outgoing personality will guarantee success in whatever field he chooses. And the wonderful thing about Andreas and other students that we've had tonight, I've heard work ethic, I've heard dedication, I've heard God first. And I think these are the things that are going to create hope for us, for our future. When we hear these type of characteristics that are being spoken about our students, it's very important that we support them. And we know they've had a fabulous start. So just as we have parents who are good role models, give our children good start, or great starts actually, we look forward to people like Andreas to bring bring that hope to our future, to a reality for us. Because I think it's something we need right now. So Andreas, congratulations, and here you go.
Sorry about my appearance. This wasn't my first outfit I planned to come today. I'd like to thank the freeholders for having me, the councilman and the mayor, and Mr. Saunders who nominated, and Ms. Giddens, and my grandparents in the back who came. It means a lot to be Spanish, especially in Sickler Road. There's like not really a lot of Spanish people, so to be able to like augment the culture and be able to bring stuff from, I'm actually from Camden, so be able to bring that over here and inspire not only just Spanish kids, but everyone in general means a lot, especially in a sport like wrestling, there's not really a lot of Spanish kids. So I just feel good every day. I just want to inspire people and keep them motivated, because that's what it means to be Spanish. Keep being determined, and everyone that's Spanish, you see, they all always got this grind behind them. They always have this mentality, chip on their shoulder. They want to be better. So thank you guys for all having me today. It's a pleasure meeting all you guys, and thank you.
Krista Gonzalez, come on down. Okay, Krista is a senior at Timber Creek, and she was also nominated by her principal, Mrs. Giddens, and vice principal, Mr. Saunders. Okay, so I had this sitting on my island again last night, and my wife saw it. My wife has to be a teacher at Arrow Elementary, and she said, "Krista Gonzalez, I love her," with this big smile on her face. So this is what Mr. Saunders and Mrs. Giddens had wrote about Krista. "Krista Gonzalez, in capital letters and in quotes, outstanding, is the word associated with this senior. She is a well-rounded student who is a great representative of Timber Creek High School. Krista's strong load of honors and AP classes hasn't held her back. Not only is Krista involved in a host of community service, she is a member of the World Language Club, One Act Plays, Student Council, Senior Class Executive Board, Drama Club, Hero Club, National Honor Society, and she is the captain of the girls' soccer team. All of this, and she's able to maintain a 4.3412 GPA. Krista is a wonderful young lady who is blessed with awesome leadership abilities. Because of her leadership skills, she was able to fearlessly lead the junior class to victory over the senior class in last year's Powderpuff Games." Now, we all know the seniors are supposed to win this, right? So the underdogs did it. "Although she possesses fire while she's in competition, she is the nicest person to talk with. Krista is always available to work with other students and can be seen in the library working with the underclassmen. What a remarkable young lady. Krista, on behalf of Gloucester Township, in recognition of your exemplary leadership, outstanding service, and dedication to the people of Gloucester Township, I present to you this award. Congratulations."
I wasn't planning on crying, so I'm sorry.
It's just really good to be recognized for the good that you do, even though, because I'm not doing these things to be recognized. I do it, you know, just to do it because it's the right thing. So to know that people are actually looking and to know that I'm doing the right thing, it means a lot.
Let's see that fire. Let's see that fire, right?
Okay. Okay. I want to thank Gloucester Township for having me, especially Mayor. You probably don't know this, but when we were at the legislative program that I also took place in, because I want to major in political science, I didn't realize how much passion Mr. Mayor had for this township, and you know, his passion and wanting us to have so much unity just rubbed off of me and made me want to have unity with this township and my school. I tried so hard for my school. Oh my gosh. To keep us together, and I just want everyone to be together and have a great senior year. I try so hard for everyone to get out of their comfort zone and to be with everyone else. So I want to thank you. I also want to thank Mr. Saunders and Mrs. Givens, who is new. Thank you. And I want to thank God and my parents for making me this way, because I know I can't do it all on my own. So thanks.
Had to do multiple honorees, as we have some council members that we're missing this evening, but it gives us an opportunity to meet some new individuals or people that we normally wouldn't come across. The last honoree tonight, and certainly not last, is Caitlin Fisher.
Caitlin?
So at 4 o'clock this afternoon, I found that Councilwoman Winters couldn't be here. She had an emergency. Michelle had spoken to Caitlin over the weekend. So I said, I got to make a quick phone call. So I was traveling with my son in the car. I said, take notes. So he was writing notes on the back of an appointment card for his orthodontist. And he was taking everything that she does. And I'm trying to read his handwriting. It's terrible. But yeah. But Caitlin is a senior at Highland Regional High School. And she was nominated by her principal, Ms. Petit, and also by her guidance counselor. I know him as DJ Gore. And I actually coached with DJ way back in Kiwanis baseball. And DJ, he doesn't say nice things just to say nice things. And he said some wonderful things about Caitlin that I'll read a little bit later on at the end. But she is a senior at Highland High School. She has a 3.85 GPA, and she is part of the National Junior Honor Society. She's planning and majoring in marine biology. And I wouldn't be a good alumnus of Stockton University if I didn't push marine biology program there. Brigantine, you can go. But she's applying to two schools in Boston and two schools in Florida. So those are wise choices as well. She has been working at Taco Bell on Blackwood Clementon Road since her sophomore year. And I said, well, I've been going through that drive-through lane too much recently. The $5 deal, it's a lot of food. Good money for the price. Good, you know, good value. But she has worked there since, and I looked to my son when he was taking the notes. I said, how old did you start when you were there? She was 16. I looked at him and said, 16, start working. But she balances this by, she was part of three mission trips in through the United States. She taught Vacation Bible School at Cyclical United Methodist Church. She is part of the Transition Project team, where you appeared with a senior, works with a freshman, and help guide them through the transition period of starting high school. I know when my son was there, he spent $9 on lunch one day. He got lost this day, he needed someone to help navigate him, and you serve as a resource to help navigate freshmen that are at Highland Regional. She is the manager of the football and basketball team as well. And I'll read to you what Mr. Gore, her guidance counselor, said as part of her recommendation letters for colleges. As a natural leader, Caitlin tends to make those around her better students and better people. Most importantly, she's mature beyond her years, and her preparation and organizational skills are sure to play an important role in her future success. Furthermore, she's an absolute pleasure to work with, and her kind and humble character is reflected in her refined communication skills. I am certain Caitlin Fisher will be a positive addition to your institution, and I highly recommend her for admission into any institution. This was part of her nomination that was sent in. So on behalf of Gloucester Township Mayor and Council, I want to award you, present this to you in recognition of your exemplary leadership, your outstanding service and dedication to people of Gloucester Township, and to being a leader within your community. Congratulations.
So I want to thank my parents. I want to thank Ms. Petit and Highland. Highland has given me so many opportunities the past 4 years, and I honestly just am amazed at how much I've grown since I've gotten there. Like, I can't talk in front of people, and I'm doing it right now, so I'm kind of freaking out. But Highland and just I don't know, it's just amazing. And I want to thank everyone for everything you guys have given me and just all the chances that you've continued to give me, so thank you.
Mayor?
Before I do some closing remarks, I would like to bring forward our Assemblywoman here in the 4th Legislative District, Assemblywoman Gabriella Mascara. Gabby is the first Hispanic elected to the state legislature from the 4th Legislative District, so she is breaking down barriers, and we are so very, very, very proud of her. So, Assemblywoman, if you could please say a few words.
It's an honor and a pleasure to be here. Hispanic Heritage Month is actually one of the events here in Gloucester Township that I really enjoy. I get a kick out of being here because it's an opportunity to actually share with the residents of Gloucester Township a little bit about me. And I'm an immigrant to the United States. I was born in Ecuador. I came to this country when I was 3 years old. I've naturalized American. I became an American citizen at the age of 19. It was one of my proudest days of my life. I remember that like it was yesterday. And every time I see the American flag, and I always pledge allegiance to the flag, it takes me back to that day that I say those words, that I swore my allegiance to the American flag and to this wonderful country. So it's a very emotional. So every time I do the pledge is an emotional, and I understand that, and I know that many immigrants here can understand that. So I just want to share that with the audience. But also, I just want to congratulate the honorees here, especially the young honorees. Just listening to all of you, you are amazing individuals, and I am so excited that you're going to be such. Oh my God, I just can't wait until you 5-10 years from now, and the contributions that you're going to give back, not only to Gloucester Township, but to the state of New Jersey, and to just the society as a whole. I am so excited for you, and I'm so proud of you, and I know that your parents are very proud of you. But and I'm also going to say that I'm particularly proud of you, because as a Latina, we're all family. So just so proud of all of you. You're like my kids, but, you know. But also not the other adults here in the room, thank you for what you do, and you're amazing individuals, and thank you for doing, just being who you are, and just going day after day, and just doing what you do for the love of the thing, and not for the recognition. So I honor you, and I thank you for everything, and I just want to say thank you to Mayor and Council for having this event year after year, and for recognizing the contributions of Hispanic Americans. I'm a proud American. I love being here in the United States, but I'm also proud to be of Hispanic descent. So thank you so much to Mayor and Council for honoring us as Hispanics, and God bless you. Buenas noches.
Thank Thank you. Thank you, Assemblywoman. Krista, you're going to make me cry. So I really appreciate your kind words, and I appreciate your passion as well. Today we gather to celebrate a very rich and colorful Hispanic heritage, and we're so very proud to do that. I want to thank Father Rene for joining us here today and opening us up in prayer. Josie and Michael, thank you for your participation on the committee. The Rosado family, thank you for taking time to be with us as well. First, of course, let me offer my congratulations to all of the recipients here this evening, and certainly you are outstanding because you stand out. And so thank you for congratulations on that award, on the award. But more importantly, let me say thank you. You see, you are the special people that make Gloucester Township a great community and a great place to live. And I can't thank you enough. And I love nights like this because you hear stories of inspiration. You hear stories how you, each in your own collective way, are making a difference right here in this community. So thank you so very, very much for doing that. And let me also thank your parents. Thank you to the parents that are here today for making such great children and outstanding citizens. And I think that's so very, very important to acknowledge them as well. So on behalf of our town council and certainly myself, we wish you the very, very best to continue to make a difference in your own way and be the special people that you are. So congratulations to all of you, and thank you so very much for coming out. Adios, invios, con Dios.
If we can have all the recipients come here up here and take a picture, we're gonna have a 10-minute recess. Thank you.
Thank you. Have a good night.
Good evening, Council. Once again, another night of recognition of young people that are just absolutely impressive and incredible. They really are.
Thank you,
Ray. On Resolution 1609274, with the Shared Service Agreement on Natural Gas, what's different from this? That is from the electric aggregate.
This is a cooperative through South Jersey Industry, South Jersey Gas, through municipalities. So it's called the South Jersey Power Cooperative, and it invites local municipalities within Camden County and South Jersey to participate in it. It's for municipalities, not for residents.
The county actually went out for a bid, and I believe almost all of the municipalities, 32nd, is about to participate in that bid. And so we take advantage of the economies of scale with the reduced rates, but it's only applicable to municipal run buildings.
It won't affect the residents whatsoever?
No.
Excellent. The other item was the, redevelopment zone for Glen Oaks. It gets a little confusing when we hear that Glen Oaks redevelopment, the whole township is a redevelopment, and the standard from a normal piece of ground in Gloucester Township to something that's not redevelopment, which I guess at some point empowers council to make moves on a particular parcel of land. Could you please describe, with the Glen Oaks redevelopment, what is different from the items that are mentioned? I think Mr. Lechner always goes back to 1980-something with the redevelopment procedure in the township. Could you please describe that?
Well, when you first hear Glen Oaks, you think it's Glen Oaks, what's behind the municipal building, Glen Oaks. No, actually, it is the parcel of land that's running up Lower Landing Road. So I'm going to ask Mr. Lechner to explain the Glen Oaks area, the redevelopment area. There are a few items there on the agenda for signing agreements that will add additional ratables to our township. Mr. Lechner?
Would you like to step up to the microphone so people can hear you?
Is your question on what is proposed before council tonight, the amendment?
As a part of that, as to what, why we're individualizing Glen Oaks, constantly you refer to the township, majority of the township, if not all of it, as redevelopment zone, referring to something back in the 80s. I'm just looking for the description of what is the redevelopment and why.
Well, the Glen Oaks redevelopment area is roughly along from the Black Horse Pike along Lower Landing Road, around Lower Landing Road to across on basically on the north side of Lower Landing Road from Black Horse Pike as it goes over the under the overpass of Route 42. That's generally the Glen Oaks redevelopment area. What you're referencing was an ordinance that was adopted, I believe, in the 80s, which Township Council at the time, that was for tax abatement. And under that tax abatement statute, the whole township was determined as an area in need of blight in order for rehabilitation. So there's rehabilitation areas, which is all of the township. And there's individual redevelopment areas, which is a different statutory criteria. The Glen Oaks redevelopment plan was established in the late 1990s. And this is an amendment for a billboard on one of the lots.
A billboard?
Yes, on one lot in the redevelopment area.
Billboard,
is that a lighted billboard or just a standard billboard?
No, there's a billboard and also flex space, the warehouse space.
There's
two of them.
Mr. Lechner.
One. I'm not sure. 273. Resolution 273. 273.
Okay.
Gloucester Data Center.
Okay. The Gloucester Data Center is a application before the planning board. They're adding an addition which will make a building approximately 50,000 square feet plus. And basically the building will hold computer servers, and it, they will be energized by the solar project that is on the adjacent parcel.
That was also part of a redevelopment agreement in the past.
Right, that's the one. There's also another one regarding, I think it's just flexible space on Lower Landing Road, and it's just an amendment to the redevelopment agreement. I think they're just changing the ownership name.
And the one thing you stated back in the 80s, you said the township as a whole was noted blighted, in need of improvement. Is that correct?
I'd have to look at the actual council resolution that was passed. That's when the township was trying to receive tax abatement under the tax abatement provisions, in order so that all of Gloucester Township, you were able to receive tax abatement. A lot of municipalities, only portions of the municipality can receive tax abatement. But because all of the township received tax abatement, I think that's what that was the title of the statute back then.
Okay. I guess as a follow-up on to that, and rather than coming back up in the second public portion, I think it's time maybe the township revisit that ordinance from the 80s. And I think some folks in Gloucester Township and some pretty well-to-do areas would not find the terminology blighted in their neighborhood to be palatable. So maybe might be time to look at that, because we always go back to that reference to the 80s for the redevelopment, and maybe take another look at that, because it's 2016. It's about time. Thank you.
What's the benefit that you'd be looking for?
Well, I think anything needs to be updated when you're constantly going back to the 80s. It's not a matter of history. It's not a matter of precedent. It's a matter of what we refer to parts of this town and the ability to do things in parts of this town that we can always go. If the whole town's a redevelopment zone or blighted for in need of improvement, since the 80s, Gloucester Township's changed dramatically. I think you would all agree we had a part in all of the businesses and various other developments that have come here. It's time maybe to revisit, sit down and talk about what changes could be made. What does not necessarily have to be a redevelopment zone, because I can surely tell you there's areas that I know of in this town that are not blighted.
But Ray, is there a positive that you're seeking to obtain as a result of a reclassification?
I'm hoping when council meets, she'll decide that. Thank you.
You don't know if there's any positive that could come about.
Once again, that's if you sit down and talk about it, you may be able to establish whether there is or isn't. Along with the planning board and Mr. Lechner, you know, various other means to which you have, resources you have, maybe you can take a look and see. And if you find nothing, so be it. But I surely think that a great deal of change has come to this township that it be revisited. It surely would be.
You don't like the terminology blighted as a result?
It's not a matter of terminology. It's that we constantly go back to this when you want to do something. And it takes a different procedure when everything is a redevelopment. And it's not always advantageous to give abatements out. I'll tell you what, if I'm in a redevelopment zone where I live in the great metropolis of Ariel, I would love to have an abatement. Do you guys know where Ariel is?
I was there Saturday playing T-ball.
There you
go. I was on Essex in line.
I mean, we're part of Sicklerville. We don't even have an identity.
The heritage is on the way out.
And if I may add.
If I may add, and I'll let you go, is that this serves as a tool. It's a redevelopment tool. Because, for instance, Blackwood West. Okay? Blackwood West, I'll tell you, when the Walgreens was built on the corner of Ariel and Black Horse Pike, okay, the fact that landscaping that was done there and the streetlights were done there was part because it was a part of the Blackwood West redevelopment. Now, if a developer came into our town and there wasn't a redevelopment zone that they have to adhere to for certain standards, do you think they'll put the ornamental lighting in and they'll put in the type of facade or streetscaping that takes place there? Most likely not. So it serves as a tool to help enhance certain parts of our community. So thank you very much.
Some parts of town seem to gain a greater advantage than others. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Anyone else? Miss Sorgentino. Did I pronounce that correct? Okay. When you come up here, tell me how to pronounce it correctly. Sorgentoni.
Virgin Tony.
Thank you.
Yes. Hi. Just a statement. It's about Resolution 275, renaming the Citizens Appreciation Park, which nobody uses, for Mr. Bianchini. I think that renaming it under one person takes away from the spirit in which the park was created, which was to honor all the citizens who have volunteered their time and talents. And the fact that the monetary cost of renaming it was not a consideration shows fiscal responsibility, because we're $55 million in debt, and this is not a necessary expense. Thank you.
Okay. may I reply, or?
Well, I don't think they're going to change anything, so I'm used to not.
Well, your first comment, no one uses the park?
I've never seen anyone there.
Have you ever been to the park? Were you aware of the park before?
I know, way before this.
We discussed this, okay.
I have a friend who goes by that park twice a day, and she's never seen anyone there.
No one's ever been there. So you have an issue with it being named or being dedicated and having Mr. Bianchini's name placed on it?
I think it's wonderful the way it is. The initial statements from the mayor was that the park was there to show appreciation for all of the citizens of the township and their towns and what they've volunteered. I look, and there's a criteria for different civic organizations to nominate one person a year to have their names added to the park. I think the concept is wonderful. I think naming it after one person takes away from the honor of everyone else who has their name there. I think it should be fair and equal.
Okay, names that people can nominate individuals that have their names placed there.
Mm-hmm.
This was a gesture for Mr. Bianchini, who has been in our community since 1988, who has volunteered through several organizations. Quite frankly, Ms. Sergeant Tony, I'm not sure if you're aware of what Mr. Bianchini has done.
It doesn't matter.
May I finish, Ms. Sergeant Tony? We've gone back and forth via email.
Mm-hmm.
I've returned your emails.
Mm-hmm.
But Mr. Bianchini, not just what he did here on council. There's many hats he wore throughout this township, and this was something that was brought to our attention. We'll vote on it. There's a resolution. I think it's a wonderful thing. Mr. Seiler was recognized here, and Mr. Seiler, Veterans Park. We still refer to it as Veterans Park, but Lieutenant Colonel Sam Seiler, Veterans Park, for the contributions he made to our community. But this happens once in a while. Mr. Bianchini made tremendous contributions to our community, and I do respect your opinion. But this is something that we have a resolution, and we'll see how the vote goes.
Did you find out the cost?
The cost of it, they're going to put Glenn Bianchini on top of the sign.
And that's going to cost?
I did not come up with a cost. Tom, can you get a cost for me?
I will.
Okay.
Okay.
And if there's an additional cost, Ms. Sergeant Tony, I will pay for that cost out of my pocket.
That's wonderful.
To put his name on there.
That's wonderful.
Thank you very much. We can do a payment plan if it exceeds a certain amount. All right. Ms. Scott.
Got your back.
It's his birthday today, shit. So.
Dwayne Clark, Timber Birch. I have a question about the first ordinance about the abandoned properties.
Okay.
Could you explain that a little more? I was talking with Dan earlier, but.
So there is a law. It's called New Jersey Abandoned Property Rehabilitation Act. And this allows a township if they can identify certain properties that have been abandoned. But they have to meet a certain criteria. For instance, they have to be abandoned for at least 6 months. There is an individual that's considered the public officer that will be appointed by Gloucester Township Council. In this ordinance, it indicates that the public officer would be Mr. Cardis, the business administrator. In his opinion, he's also the public works, oversees public works, is that property in need of rehabilitation? Has it been vacant for 6 months? Was construction started on the project and discontinued, and it has to be completed? Is there some type of public safety issue that's in place? Has there been one installment of taxes that have been delinquent? And the last criteria, is it determined to be a nuisance by the public? So we have an entity that will take the property, rehab the property, and then that's part of their portfolio, or they could resell it. And that entity
Who is that entity?
That entity would be the Gloucester Township Housing Authority.
Okay.
and the funds that they would use is COA money, the Council on Affordable Housing. That money is generated when developers come into Gloucester Township and they, when they have a specific project, let's say they're going to build 100 homes, a certain percentage of them in the past had to be dedicated to low and moderate income housing, and that's part of the state law. So that money is just sitting in a pot. Mr. Lechner, I'm not even going to ask how much money is sitting in the pot, or Mr. Cardis, but it's money that can help with this particular program.
Over half the money.
So what happens once they get the houses rehabilitated? They sell the houses? Who owns the houses once the housing authority takes over?
We would take possession. Gloucester Township would take possession of the property.
But not ownership.
Not ownership. Gloucester Township Housing Authority is the entity that would rehab it, secure it, and
so
sell.
Once it's rehabbed, it's sold?
Yes.
And who takes in the monies from the sale?
Well, the statute in New Jersey provides a measure that has to be sold at market value once it's completely rehabbed. The process allows the township through the courts to become priority as a lien holder on that property. If there are mortgages or other judgment lien holders and the property is abandoned, the township can go in under this statute and this ordinance to bond or come up with the dollars to expend for the rehab. Under court order, we then have priority over every mortgage holder or judgment holder if we take that step. So we use our dollars to get the property reconditioned, rehab, and then we have to sell it at market value. As part of our fair share housing plan, this process is mentioned in our fair share housing plan under COA. So if it goes up for market value sale and it's purchased through the housing authority, then it's allowed to use COA funds. Those funds are paid back to the township. The township gets reimbursed first before every mortgage holder or judgment holder.
Okay. And then, so what if there's any, after everybody's paid, if there's any further monies realized, who sees that realization? The township? The housing authority?
There would not be any under the scenario of the houses I think you're going to identify, but my sense is if the township gets its dollars, the mortgage holders get their dollars, judgment holders, if there's anything left, it goes to the owner who's available.
Okay. Because as I was telling Dan, and I've told you before, I have two vacant houses on my block, and they've been vacant for 2, maybe 3 years, and the township comes and cuts the grass every couple, they were just there this week. The one I think is probably involved with a bank situation. It was a young girl. She fixed that property nicely. It's not in too much need, but the bank is probably involved. The other one has been in need forever. They were original owners and they didn't do much. So I can see that one going. But every time I came before you to see about it, you said, they're paying their taxes. We can't do anything about it. Now you can, correct?
Absolutely. In addition to that, if you recall, we passed a resolution, an ordinance for a mortgage identification program. So if a home, this was passed 4 or 5 months ago, perhaps, maybe 3 months ago.
It was, we recently.
Oh, we amended that.
Yeah.
Because we are partnering with Gloucester County, where and a entity that would help identify if a home was left, they foreclosed or to just abandon the property, that property would be identified. Because one of the issues that we have is identifying who's paying taxes, who's the mortgage company on this property. So partnering with, the original thought was partnering with Gloucester County and this entity that will identify them. They will contact the mortgage holder and then hold their feet to the fire. At least we know who we can contact. We recently passed a resolution to amend because now that is being done in Camden County as well as a shared service. So we have that. We have our neighborhood enhancement program that our public works goes out. If there is a building that needs to be boarded up or a building that grounds that need to be maintained, that's taking place. And this is just, the third leg in adding to that, where we can take a property that has been vacant for 6+ months. They haven't paid the taxes on it. It's a public safety issue, or maybe a building or a house that was being erected or built that wasn't completed, that we have an opportunity to take that property, rehab it, and then put it out on the market.
Okay. Once this is passed tonight, what kind of time frame do you expect before you can start working on these different
Well, it's an ordinance, so it has to have a second reading, and after it's passed, it's 20 days after that for it to go into effect.
Well, I'm appreciative, and I'm sure my neighbors are very appreciative.
Thank you, Ms.
Thank you.
Anyone else? Mr. Sweet.
Sam Sweet from Ariel.
Good evening.
Good evening, Council. Good evening. Did I hear you correctly? You were playing T-ball?
Oh, no, I coached.
Just wondering, because the last council meeting you said you didn't play baseball, so I was wondering.
No.
Okay.
My son stopped playing baseball, so I said, you got to do something. So we coach a T-ball team.
Okay. I just heard playing T-ball, so I had to ask. Just a quick question on the mortgage program. How are the houses determined? Like, if I have two houses also on my street that are abandoned. They've been abandoned for about four or five years.
I think that if we would receive phone calls that go into public works, Mr. Cardis, is that something? How would we identify these particular abandoned properties?
I don't know that they've come up with a final determination of that. That's Mr. Riccio at the
Housing Authority. Okay.
I believe what they would like to do is concentrate in certain areas. There was some discussion of the Brittany Woods area and Presidential Drive, Revere 1, Revere 2, looking at some of those properties.
Is there a number I can call to say, hey, we look at these two houses because the grass grows higher? I call like once a month and say, hey, someone needs to come cut the grass. You guys do, but it always...
Through Public Works, our Neighborhood Enhancement Program, and also Code Enforcement.
Okay, all right.
Just for the record, we're not just boarding properties up. We're fixing gutters.
Yes.
I mean, extending.
Yeah, no, but these houses are, one's like falling apart. The siding is discolored. It's, you know, obviously bringing down property value.
So beyond just boarding up.
You're fixing up. No, that's fine. I just want to know if there was a way to go about,
I don't know if this program is going to be designed to basically take a house that's mold-ridden. I mean, that could be a tremendous expenditure. And I think we shouldn't expect too much from it too soon, though.
Yes, I agree with
that. I mean, you really got to... I would rather see them slowly identify easy targets and build momentum.
And that's the game plan.
All right. With the resolution 1609-264, with the Cross Keys MZL LLC, see you're putting a Taco Bell in?
Yes.
I don't know if this is an agenda, but just kind of, we've heard rumors for years that there's a Cracker Barrel coming in and an Olive Garden.
I want a Cracker Barrel.
Any truth?
Mr. Lackley, you heard any rumblings? They keep teasing me with Cracker Barrel too, so I know. Yeah.
Just asking.
Not recently. We did speak with them about two or three years ago, but between us and Deptford, and they went either place. So.
Yeah, they were looking at going at the shops across Keys, and that just fell through.
All right.
They were looking to go where Hobby Lobby is now.
Mm-hmm. That's it. That's all I got.
Thank you. Anyone else? Seeing none, we'll close the first public portion. Bids.
Broker of record, health insurance.
Motion to accept.
Second.
On the question, roll call.
Mr. Hutchison?
Yes.
Mr. Schmidt?
Yes.
Mrs. Stubbs?
Yes.
Mr. Mignon?
Yes.
Mr. Mercado?
Yes. Now we have our ordinances. This is our first reading. A public hearing will be at its second reading. Ordinance 0-16-13, an ordinance creating Chapter 59B of the Code of Township of Gloucester entitled Neighborhood Rehabilitation Program, pursuant to the New Jersey Abandoned Properties Rehabilitation Act, NJSA 5519-78, etc. As explained earlier, this is a rehabilitation program. Where we would identify a public official who would be the
business administrator to work with an entity, which would be the housing authority, a qualified rehabilitation entity, that will identify properties throughout the township utilizing COA money, Council of Affordable Housing money, to rehab such properties. I entertain a motion.
I'll make that motion.
Is there a second?
Second.
On the question, Madam Clerk, roll call, please.
Mr. Hutchison?
Yes.
Mr. Schmidt?
Yes.
Mrs. Stubbs?
Yes.
Mr. Minion?
Yes.
Mr. Mercado?
Yes. Ordinance 0-16-14 is ordinance of the Township of Gloucester, County of Camden, State of New Jersey, adopting Amendment Number 5, amending Ordinance 0-97-17, commonly known as the Glen Oaks Redevelopment Plan, to allow one billboard on Block 4101, Lot 4, as a permitted use pursuant to NJSA 48-12A-1, etc. This will allow a billboard on Lower Landing Road in the Glen Oaks redevelopment area plan. I entertain a motion.
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
On the question, roll call, Madam Clerk.
Mr. Hutchison?
Yes.
Mr. Schmidt?
Yes.
Mrs. Stubbs?
Yes.
Mr. Mignon?
Yes.
Mr. Mercado?
There will be a second reading after this goes to the planning board.
Yes.
Oh, yes. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I interrupted.
Carla, Mayor. All right. Ordinance 0-16-15 is ordinance amending Chapter 81 of the Code of the Township of Gloucester entitled Vehicles and Traffic of the Code of the Township of Gloucester. Chapter 81 allows the municipality to ticket vehicles in specific areas, traffic regulations. Regulation of movement and parking of traffic on private property open to the public where the public's invited. The following areas are identified: Commerce Square, Blackwood Clementon Road. This will alleviate some of the overnight parking that takes place there. Gloucester Township Premium Outlets, Reliable Tires on 805 North Black Horse Pike. The Cherrywood Plaza on Blackwood Clementon Road, the Marketplace at Choose Landing, the ShopRite area, Choose Landing area, and 1370 Blackwood Clementon Road as well, to eliminate overnight parking. I entertain a motion.
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
On the question, roll call, Madam Clerk.
Mr. Hutchison?
Yes.
Mr. Schmidt?
Yes.
Mrs. Stubbs?
Yes.
Mr. Mignon?
Yes.
Mr. Mercado?
Yes. Next, we have a resolution of the consent agenda. Before I ask any council member if they'll want to entertain a motion, on resolution 1609-269 to designate the intersection of Summerdale Road as a front at the exit of Chews Elementary School, do not block the box. That has been amended. They had the wrong, Madam Clerk, was the wrong section of Summerdale Road?
Yes, it was.
So. At your desk, on your dais, there is an updated resolution amended. So, I obtain a motion to amend. We're going to amend 269. Is there a motion?
I'll make that motion.
Is there a second?
Second.
On the question, roll call, Madam Clerk, for 269 to amend.
Mr. Hutchison?
Yes.
Mr. Schmidt?
Yes.
Mrs. Stubbs?
Yes.
Mr. Mignon?
Yes.
Mercado.
Yes, to amend. Now, we have our consent agenda. Any council member that would like to remove any of the agenda items, please speak up. Hearing none, I entertain a motion to accept the agenda as presented with the amendment.
I'll make that motion.
Is there a second?
Second.
On the question. Roll call, Madam Clerk.
Mr. Hutchison?
Yes.
Mr. Schmidt?
Yes.
Mrs. Stubbs?
Yes.
Mr. Mignon?
Yes.
Mr. Mercado?
Yes. One thing I wanted to highlight on Resolution 273 that was brought up, two things. The billboard in the Glen Oaks redevelopment area, people have asked about the clicks and seeing Gloucester Township when they advertise the PSA announcement. On that particular billboard, there is agreement where the township is generating revenue. For the first 5 years, we received 12% of the net revenue of that billboard. That was part of the agreement that was signed with the developer for that billboard. And in the next 6 to 15 years, we receive 6% of the net revenue, not to exceed $45,000 for each year. Second, on Resolution 273, the Gloucester Data Center, currently there's roughly 20,000 square feet and they're adding a data center there, as Mr. Lechner talked about earlier, next to the solar panels that will add an additional 35,000 square feet. So 55,000 square feet and additional ratables for our township. Regular agenda, resolution 275.
Resolution of the Township Council of the Township of Gloucester, Camden County, New Jersey, dedicating the recognition of former Council President Glenn Bianchini to the Gloucester Township Citizens Appreciation Park for his dedication and service to the residents of the Township of Gloucester.
I'll entertain a motion.
I'll make that motion.
Is there a second?
Second.
On the question, roll call.
Mr. Hutchison?
Yes.
Mr. Schmidt?
Yes.
Mrs. Stubbs?
Yes.
Mrs. Winters? Mr. Mercado.
Yes. Just a note, Mr. Mignone.
Yes.
Okay. Just to note that on October 15th, ceremony honoring individuals that have been nominated will take place at the Citizens Appreciation Park. I believe it is 10 o'clock in the morning. You can look on the website for additional information. But these are individuals that have been nominated for their volunteer from different organizations throughout the township. We do not have any GTGov access emails. We'll now open the second public portion. This is open up to any item. We do have a time limit of 5 minutes per speaker with a maximum of 30 minutes. Ms. Carr.
Joanne Carr, Timber Birch. A couple of weeks ago, I attended a rally in support of our police and our first responders. And there weren't so many people as we anticipated, but it was really ungodly hot. And 3 days after that, my 86-year-old neighbor across the street had someone knock on the door and say, I need a drink of water. And she went to her kitchen sink, and she heard him and turned around, and he was running out of her house with her handbag. Now, that day, my street, I had been out pruning. There were Jehovah's Witnesses walking up and down the street. There were women from the Women's Club delivering flyers. My sister arrived with her granddaughter. It was a lot of traffic. And this happened, within minutes, our police force was there. There had to be four or five police cars. This was noon on a Tuesday afternoon. And our police officers stayed with that lady. They helped her take care of her credit cards, her driver's license, her registration. They called a locksmith to come and change the locks on her house and on her car. The detective came, they were in and out all day, and then they went about their business because they were looking for cameras or whatever. I don't know the disposition of what happened with the man who took her money, her bag, but the Gloucester Township Police stayed with my neighbor until 5:30 in the afternoon, until after the locksmith came. And he didn't even leave until the locksmith left because he didn't want to leave her alone with someone she didn't know. I am so proud of our police department. And I've always known they were good, but this comes from a leadership and a protocol that they have in place that our citizens are protected so well. If there's another rally, I really hope to see a lot more people there because I really want to thank the police department. I mean, it makes me feel better. I mean, these things happen. Everybody's locking their door now. Everybody's a little nervous and upset. But at least we know our police are there for us. So, thank you.
Thank you very much. Anyone else? Mr. Sweet?
Sam Sweet from Ariel. I was at the Field of Dreams committee meeting, and the treasurer of the Rotary Club, went through the finances of it. And he said that they had applied for a $75,000 grant that was erroneously made out to Gloucester Township instead of Gloucester Township Rotary Club. And to this date, that check still hasn't found its way to the Rotary Club.
I had spoken to, because I heard that that was a point of contention in the meeting, the $75,000. Up until Wednesday of last week, that's the first time I ever heard of that. I know that there was an application, I think that of $25,000 that was made for open space that was from the county. But I had contacted the business administrator. He was not aware of the $75,000, because if money is coming from an entity such as Camden County through open space or a grant, it would go to the municipality and then they would park it with the Rotary or dedicate it towards those funds for Field of Dreams. So I'm going to contact Mr. Castor tomorrow morning and have a conversation with him. Because
he would have been here. He's on vacation.
Okay.
He said he would have gotten
his cell phone. I know Joe very well, so I'll give him a call. But I know Mr. Mignon had brought that up. I was not aware of 75. If we were sitting on 75, we would dedicate it, we would earmark that for the field. But when I spoke to the mayor as well, he had also said, I think 25 through open space or a grant through the county. But I want to get some clarification from Joe regarding that $75,000. Because if our business administrator is not aware of that, then that's an issue. I don't think he's sitting on $75,000.
I was just asking. That was at the meeting, so I was just kind of asking. He also wanted to know, the treasurer wanted to know, if you did have it, was it in an interest-bearing account for the past 3 years?
Okay.
Our CFO is also in money. Should be back by tomorrow. Should be in the office with.
But I'll give Mr. Castor a call and get some clarification on that. And thank you very much for attending.
You're welcome. A couple of questions regarding that. Apparently, we're switching the field from Gloucester Township Park to
Valley Brook. Yes.
And Valley Brook, the field's already been turfed.
Yes.
Why are we switching it, other than the fact that the field was already been turfed? Why did we switch it in the first place?
Well, the biggest impediment and obstacle that we had for Field of Dreams is that we didn't have a field. It was the funds for it. When the turf field was put in at the Valley Brook complex, the decision was made to put additional turf on a softball field that is underutilized. Quite frankly, it's used once a year for a tournament. So that field was put, turf was put on that field to alleviate some of the dirt coming onto the turf field that TBA utilizes. So having that there, in discussions with the mayor and also the business administrator, we installed ADA compliant dugouts. Money that is sitting with Rotary will be utilized for ADA improvements to the building and access to the area, including a parking lot. So I believe that was something, a source of an obstacle in your meeting that you had. That area, that part of what we're trying to do, that's something that the administration will handle. What we're trying to do is put a structure together. That was the charge, to put a structure together that we can have a season operating in the spring of 2017.
But wasn't the original, there was a groundbreaking, the mayor with the shovel, council over Gloucester Township Park, so why did we switch it?
Because we have a field.
Wasn't there a field at Gloucester Township?
Excuse me?
Wasn't there a field at Gloucester Township?
There was additional work that would have to be done there. And you're talking about maybe $600,000 more on top of if we added that to the bond. So we have it. We have a field. That, again, Sam, that was the biggest impediment. I know that was a question you brought over and over again.
Because,
Sam, we have a field.
Okay, I understand that. All right, and you can keep saying we had a field, and I'm going to still ask the question, because I want to know why Valley Brook is, yes, there's a field. We have a field at Gloucester Township. All right, so were there a cost analysis study done? Have we gotten construction crews out there to look at the fields to determine why that field's 100, field could be 150,000, 300,000. Was that stuff done?
Mrs. Carnes?
An estimate was done on that field, and it came in the vicinity of $600,000.
By whom?
by the engineer, Pettit Associates.
Okay, that's all I'm asking. Was
in
just want to know.
In fact, it was, I believe, one of the options in the bid specs. So we actually have hard numbers on there from a contractor.
Okay, that's all I'm trying to get at is why it was switched. And if you're telling me that one side was more expensive than the other and we have a field, and that's simple. Why can't we get the simple answer without trying to tell me that we have a field?
Well, Sam, I was giving you a simple answer.
But sometimes the simple answer isn't the right answer,
Mr. Sweet,
or the answer that we're looking for.
Mr. Sweet, the largest obstacle and impediment we had was not having a field. We have a field. We need a structure in place. That's what that task force is charged with.
We had a field at Gloucester Township Park. Yes, it might have cost more money.
You have dugouts?
But we still
have a turf field? You don't have any of those
things.
We
don't have access roads to Valley Brook. Oh.
That's what the $137,000 is going to go towards.
But according to the treasurer, he's only got $48,000 in the account.
I will speak to the treasurer tomorrow morning. He had indicated to me at $137,000, I'll find out what that accounting is from him.
Okay. I mean, Mr. Mignon, you heard those numbers, right? I mean,
yes.
Am I incorrect on those numbers?
Yes. Yes, you are.
I'm incorrect on the numbers?
No, you're correct.
Oh.
Am I correct?
Okay.
Yes, you are correct. Those were the numbers that were spoken at the meeting.
Okay. And that's where the confusion lies.
But money that was raised will be used for improvements at the Valley Brook Complex to provide access to the field.
And what about parking?
Parking as well. And also ADA improvements to the bathrooms, the restrooms.
All right. Okay.
Thank you very
much.
Thanks for coming last Wednesday. Anyone else? Seeing none, we'll close the public portion. Polling the directors.
Mr. Blackner?
I have nothing to comment. Thank you.
Captain Weiser?
I have nothing. Thank you.
Mr. Carlin?
Nothing to report.
Mr. Cardis?
Nothing.
Polling the council. Mr. Rogerson?
Tracy, thank you very much for coming out tonight. And I alluded to Jose Fernandez earlier this evening and his passing and what he meant to the Cuban-American community in Miami, Florida, the United States. He was truly doing great things, not just as a baseball player, but as a human being and trying to make a difference. I too appreciate the police department, and I recognize what's going on in this community. I'm very thankful that we have the police department that we do have. Thank you very much for coming.
Mr. Schmidt.
I would like to thank and congratulate all of the honorees this evening, and thank everyone for coming out. Thank you for your comments.
Mrs. Stubbs.
I'd like to thank everyone for coming out. Hope to see everyone at the Pumpkin Festival that will be coming up. Hope everyone will be there to support Township and the various groups and vendors that will be there. Thanks for coming out.
Mr. Mignon?
I'd like to also thank everybody for coming out, and what a great night to recognize great people who are doing great things. With October approaching, that's Breast Cancer Awareness Month, so for the men and females, please get your mammograms. Thank you.
Mr. Nakata?
I want to thank everyone for coming out this evening. Congratulate our honorees. And for those who sat through the program, I want to thank you. Many times people skip out on the first hour or so because they don't want to sit here and hear the stories of some of the people that are making a contribution to our community. So I want to thank those that stayed the entire evening. On behalf of the Gloucester Township Police Department, K-9 Nationals trials continue throughout the week in Community Park, in the Lakeland Complex, and again concludes with a demo and fireworks at Timber Creek High School from 4:30 to 8 o'clock. Thank you very much for coming out this evening. I entertain a motion to adjourn. Is there a second?
Second.
All those in favor? Thank you. Have a great evening.